RIO3224D3 and RIO1608D3 are the new generation of IO racks for use with Yamaha digital mixing systems, including Rivage PM series, DM7 series, CL and QL series, and even the small yet mighty DM3 digital mixing console. They include additional processing for outputs and a configurable headphone port. Let's see how to navigate the controls from their front panels. The two sizes of RIO-D3 have the same front panel controls and rear panel connections for power and network. The differences are the number of inputs and outputs available on the front. 32 in, 24 out, or 16 in, 8 out. Aside from the new headphone port and level control, there are four keys, a rotary encoder, and a coloured light bar around the perimeter of an LCD display. Let's begin with the home screen, where you see the unit ID, the device label, and the status bar. The status bar will show if there are any warning messages, if the device is locked or muted, and if it is connected to a network. If your environment is particularly bright or dim, you may need to adjust the screen. Press and hold the back key to see contrast and brightness settings, then adjust with the encoder while still holding the back key. Pressing the menu home key will reveal the menu with the four headings of setup, control, system, and DANTE. Setup and control are for configuration, while system and DANTE are for displaying information. Scroll through the menus with the encoder, push to select, and press back to exit. In the setup menu, you can set the unit ID. Anything from Y000 to Y07F, which is 128 hexadecimal numbers. Make sure each RIO D3 or D2 unit in the same system has a different ID number. Startup mode can be selected. Refresh with mute is the default, which keeps the audio muted until the unit is synchronized with a control device or software. Refresh without mute and resume without mute are the other options. Use one of these in situations where you trust the audio output systems that are connected and the personnel in charge of them. Use resume without mute if you wish to use the RIO unit without a console connected to it. Sec port or secondary port has the usual DANTE options for daisy chain or redundant, where daisy chain is the same as what DANTE controller software calls switched mode. Use this for small and simple systems without requiring separate network switches. Moving on, the fan speed can be either low or high. When set low, the noise criteria of NC20 is met for RIO3224D3 and NC15 for RIO1608D3, so they can be used in quiet theatres and broadcast studios. Use high speed in hotter climates like at outdoor summer festivals. Brightness is from 0 to 20 for the LCD and color bar below. Contrast is also 0 to 20 with 10 as the default. The bar's normal color can be set to green, blue, or off, unless it is indicating a warning status message. Bar action can be on, blink, or off to determine its behavior when a warning is indicated. Impedance can be set to either 600 or 10K, which equates to an impedance of 600 ohms and 10 kilo ohms. Select the one to suit your analog output equipment. 10K is the default and is suited to modern professional devices with high impedance inputs. Change it to 600 if the equipment connected to the RIO-D3 outputs are likely to be older devices with lower input impedance. The final item in the setup menu is for initialize. You can return to the factory preset or just the current parameters, that is the input and output port settings, or the DANTE settings for when you want to connect to a new network but keep the input and output port settings. Back in the top menu, let's take a look at the control menu where you configure the network port and the DANTE port settings. The network port is for device control and monitoring for use when a device other than a mixing console needs access. It can be joined to a network separate from DANTE. Select from static or DHCP modes. Set the IP address, subnet mask, and default gateway in the following pages. The next four pages show similar settings for the DANTE port, though they need to be in a different subnet to the network port. Note that this is setting the IP address for device control from other equipment in the DANTE network, not for DANTE audio transmission. It is used by mixing consoles to control the parameters of the RIO unit through the DANTE network. By default, it is set to DHCP, where the network settings get made automatically and will be in the same subnet as the DANTE audio connections. You won't need to use the network port if all the control you need is accessed from a mixing console and DANTE controller software. It's primarily there for installations which require some additional device control and monitoring kept separate from the DANTE network. The IP addresses used by the DANTE ports for audio transmission can only be set in the DANTE controller application. My advice would be to leave all the DANTE network settings at their defaults, unless you are completely sure about what you are doing with IP addresses. So, let's leave them alone and move on to the system menu. Notice the spanner icon has been replaced by an I for information. In the system menu, you can view information about the device but not change it. The device name, firmware version, hardware version, DANTE version, system, and sync information. Sync will show a notice if a DANTE port has lost connection. The DANTE menu also shows us the device name and then also informs us of the sample rate, encoding, latency, preferred leader, secondary port status, and link information for the primary and secondary ports. This is just for information. It cannot be edited here. Use DANTE controller software for making such changes. Device lock, AES 67 mode, and DANTE domain manager status are also viewable here, but again, use DANTE software tools for that kind of configuration. Moving to the phone's meter key, this is where input and output port parameters can be accessed, as well as viewing the level meters and selecting which ports to hear in your headphones. The first option in the phone's screen is to select the sound source for the left channel of the headphones. As you scroll through the ports, you can see the front panel highlight the selection. Choose from any input or output port. Notice there are also two DANTE channels exclusive to the headphone selection. Using DANTE controller, you can set these up to monitor any audio signal in the DANTE network, which is transmitting with the same sample rate. Patch another DANTE audio device transmitter to the last two receivers of the RIO-D3. By default, the headphones deliver a mono signal to both ears, but you can press and hold the encoder to move to the right channel selection. Then you can select a different channel for the right ear, or return to mono again. If you select an input or output port, its main parameters are presented on the screen, and you can scroll through them with the encoder. Turn to adjust and push to move to the next parameter. For inputs, you see HA gain, phantom power, high pass filter with frequency. For outputs, you see gain, phase reverse or polarity, and delay with time in milliseconds. Press the back key to return to the channel selection. Press the phone's meter key again to view the input level meters. Press again to scroll through the additional input and output meter pages. Use the encoder to select a particular channel, which is highlighted by the front panel LEDs. Then press the encoder to access the port's parameters. Turn the encoder to adjust. Press again to advance. For inputs, gain compensation settings can be found here, in addition to the other parameters we have already seen. Though, of course, you're more likely to be adjusting them from a mixing console. For outputs, the gain range is from minus 96 to plus 24, while the delay is in 1 millisecond steps. Again, use a mixing console whenever you can to set these parameters, where you will be able to adjust delay by relative distance or number of frames or a specific number of samples. The final key, function, acts as a shortcut for up to four of the pages we have seen so far. Return to the menu or selection you wish to bookmark, then press and hold function to set it. Once the four selections are made, each time you press function, it will scroll through the saved screens. This is useful for reaching specific channel parameters quickly or for viewing other critical information. In case the four function pages are already assigned, press and hold function again to edit or remove some of the saved bookmarks. Press menu home to return to the home screen, where the unit ID and operating status is shown again. Even with this size of screen, a lot of information is accessible and a wide range of parameters can be adjusted. Of course, use a mixing console or R remote software for the full control experience, but it's good to know that you don't have to if you don't wish to. Lastly, if you need to lock the front panel controls to avoid accidental adjustment, press and hold menu home with the back key for 3 seconds or more. Then do the same to unlock. Find my other videos to see how RIO-D3 connects with a DM7 console and learn more about their unique advantages. Bye for now.